Lilius Watson remembers the day clearly.
That's when my whole world turned upside down.
She was living in Canada and diagnosed with cholangiocarcinoma, also known as bile duct cancer. She was in the process of moving to Boston and decided to have her cancer treated at Dana-Farber Cancer Institute and went to see Dr. Douglas Rubinson.
I looked at him and I said, Dr. Rubinson, am I going to die?
Dr. Rubinson offered Lilius hope, despite being diagnosed with a cancer that's typically considered rare.
It was luckily found early.
Dr. Rubinson says cholangiocarcinoma is not actually as rare as once believed. That research now indicates that many cancers, once considered cancers of unknown primary origin, actually originated in the bile ducts. That knowledge is opening the door to more research and a more effective way to diagnose these cancers.
We don't have a good screening system for cholangiocarcinoma, so the key for having the chance to be cured is to detect it when it's early, when it has not yet spread.
Research is helping doctors understand that bile duct cancer is not just one cancer type, but rather several diseases under one umbrella. Knowing that can help doctors better target treatments, especially since research shows about 30% of bile duct cancers have a genetic driver.
We feel really strongly here that anyone with a bile duct cancer needs to have their cancer tested, sequenced, to look for whether they have an Achilles heel that we have a drug that can go after.
In Lilius's case, screening after an earlier surgery is what caught her cancer early enough to effectively treat. She's received chemotherapy and radiation and has had a great response. Her doctors hope will be long-lasting.
So hope everybody could have the result I'm having today. I'm 59 years old, and I thank God every day.
Dr. Rubinson says current research is also working to see if they can unlock an immunotherapy response in bile duct cancers as well. For Dana-Farber News, I'm Victoria Warren.